Tech Cocktail Conversations, candid insights from startup founders, entrepreneurs, and thought leaders from around the globe.
My name is Dave Simnick, and I'm the co-founder and CEO of Soapbox Soaps. And if you would have told me like 2 years ago that I'd be running a soap company, I would have laughed at you. So every time that we sell a bar of soap or any one of our products, we donate a bar of soap to a child in need anywhere in the world. So whether it's across the globe, in any one of the ongoing partnerships, we partner with as big as UNICEF and as small as community groups, or whether it's down the street at the local homeless shelter or food pantry or Women and Children Abuse Center, we just try to do as much good that we can in the world. So the reason we started with soap is because there's about 24,000 children under the age of 5 that die every day from preventable disease. And specifically, out of that 24,000 every day, there's 3,000 that die because they don't have access to clean water and soap. So there's a lot of people like Charity Water or Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation that are focusing on the water aspect, and we decided to focus on the aspect that wasn't being taken care of, which is soap. Now, in the developed world, or primarily in the United States culture, the idea of using soap is just, it's ingrained since birth. After you go to the bathroom, wash your soap. Before you eat, you know, wash with soap. If you get dirty, you see dirt on your hands, just wash with soap. And around the world, that's not the case. And a lot of that is because of access, but really it's about education and culture. So the thing that we really focus on as a company is trying to ingrain this idea that washing your hands should be thoughtless. It should happen the moment you start to see your hands get dirty, or the moment you're actually going to use your hands to ingest something, you should wash with soap. And that can prevent tons and tons of diseases. So before vaccinations, before big development projects, something as simple as a bar of soap could really save lives. What inspired me to be an entrepreneur was this consistent yearning for a greater challenge. I wanted to do something meaningful. I wanted to do something that was going to every day present me with a new list of things I had no idea how to do, how to tackle, how to work through. I wanted something that was going to get me up early in the morning and have me work late into the evening, that really challenged me, whether it be through leadership or whether it be through making a significant difference to make this world a better place, or whether it just be, how do you convince people to believe in you? Like that's the thing that I just love about entrepreneurship. I think entrepreneurs, one of the biggest things, if you ask enough, and I know you guys have, I think probably one of the common themes you'll find among entrepreneurs is this yearning to do better. Someone asked me and they said, what is the thing about entrepreneurship that if you really could sum up, just like a couple words, I believe in better. I believe that things could be better, and I believe that better people can go around and solve them through better solutions. What I would say to any entrepreneur who's just getting, right on the starting blocks and they're trying to figure out, how do I tell my story? How do I share my product with the world? Start with the budget of zero. Everything should cost zero. And the reason everything should cost zero is your friends and family will promote your idea because they care about you. But after that, people need to care about what you're doing. What's your venture? So if you can start with a budget of zero and you can get people to start talking about what you're doing and it has real, meaningful value to their lives, that's the greatest A/B test out there. I mean, if you want to validate your idea, you shouldn't have to have a marketing budget. It should be able to start growing by itself. Once it starts getting that traction, that's where you throw fuel on the fire. That's where you start putting money behind PR campaigns and so on and so forth. What we did when we were just starting out is we actually stood on these corners of streets and we had our bars with us and we just said, hey, every time you buy this, another goes to a kid. You wanna hear our story? And half the time people were like, no, I don't care about the Church of Latter-day Saints. Like, no thanks, Mormon. And we were just like, no, we're not trying to, these aren't Bibles. These are actually, and after we started talking to enough people, they started being like, wow, I really love this idea. And that early validation started to show us that if you start with a budget of zero, if you take this idea of, oh God, before you start going out and just spending tens of thousands of dollars, which a lot of people make the mistake of, they think, for me to be professional, for this to be a real company, I need consultants. Consultants look at you and say, here's someone who doesn't know what they're doing, and I'm gonna be able to charge them a fortune. And that's where a lot of people's runways get so much shorter, because they're just like, hey, I need these people's expertise in order to be better. You don't have the foundation yet. Build the foundation for free. And then add that fuel to the fire.